Hello everyone. I hope you and your family are safe during this COVID-19 pandemic situation. My name is Farima Zakaryayi and I'm a medical doctor at the Kordofan University of Medical Science, Sanandaj, Iran. I want to present one case of coronavirus disease in a child with thrombocytopenia and skin lesion. WHO announced COVID-19 on February 2020. Infected children often have gastrointestinal symptoms compared with adults. Many of the infected children are symptom-free. In this study, we report one case of coronavirus disease in a child with thrombocytopenia and skin lesion who was admitted to Behzat Hospital in Sanandaj, Iran. In April 2020, a 7-year-old girl referred to an emergency department of Behzat Hospital in Sanandaj, Iran, with 4 days history of fever and erythematous maculopapular skin lesion. The skin lesions first appeared on the trunk and then gradually spread to the patient's entire abdomen and back, extending to the upper and the lower limbs. The lesions were slightly itchy. Also, one day after the onset of fever, she had started to vomit several times and then diarrhea started. The fever didn't control despite using drugs. She had no past medical history of a specific disease. Also, none of her family members were ill and had not traveled in the past few months. When checking into the emergency department, her general appearance was ill and her primary vital signs were temperature 39 degrees, O2 saturation 95%, respiratory rate 28, and pulse rate was 130. Physical examination revealed white and dry tongue and pharyngeal erythema. Also, erythematous maculopapular lesion on the back and abdomen were evident, and the urticarial lesion between the fingers and the papules were seen individually on the forearm and arm as well as on the knee and legs. You can see the maculopapular lesions on the abdomen in this figure. The initial laboratory test result of the patient's examination were following the table below. As you can see, the patient had leukocytosis and thrombocytopenia. Ultrasound showed moderate amount of free fluid in the abdomen and pelvic cavities and multiple lymph nodes with a maximum size of 21 by 9 mm were evident in the right lower quadrant of the abdomen. After stabilizing the patient, we monitored her in the pediatric department of the hospital, and she received one dose of IVIG. Chest CT scan was requested for the patient due to the prevalence of coronavirus disease and lack of the cause for thrombocytopenia and gastrointestinal symptoms, but the chest CT scan was normal. On the second day of hospitalization, skin lesions became reticular, also echocardiography performed to rule out Kawasaki. In echocardiography, evidence of myocarditis was seen and ejection fraction reported to be 10%. A few hours after echocardiography, she developed symptoms of severe respiratory distress with extensive lower extremity edema and abdominal distension, and skin lesion became disappeared. Therefore, the chest CT has done again. In chest CT scan, low intensity pleural effusions on both sides with greater severity on the right side and ground glass opacity in the peripheral part of both lungs reported. Due to the prevalence of COVID-19, PCR testing of nasopharyngeal sample was performed, which was positive for coronavirus. Therefore, the patient transferred to the intensive care unit of coronavirus patient and underwent treatment with chloroquine and calitro and meropenem and clindamycin. The patient's respiratory distress proved 2 days after the start of the treatment, and the vital signs became stable. Skin lesions completely disappeared on day 4 of the hospitalization. On the fourth days of hospitalization, echocardiography was performed again, and cardiomyopathy in context of viral infection and EF of 10% were reported. Therefore, the patient underwent treatment with dopamine and dobutamine for 5 days. She also received 1 unit of Paxil on the fifth days of hospitalization due to the drop in hemoglobin. Laboratory finding on the day 10 of hospitalization were as you see. The plaquette became normal and white BC became normal too. Finally, 10 days after hospitalization and treatment, she was discharged with a good general condition and follow-up order of echocardiography again 10 days later. So our study described erythematous maculopapular skin lesion and thrombocytopenia as the first sign of COVID-19 in a 7-year-old girl. In addition to skin lesions, our patient had other symptoms include fever, gastrointestinal symptoms like vomiting, loss of appetite, and diarrhea, respiratory distress, and cardiomyopathy. The skin's manifestations were appeared at the same time as the fever in the patient and lasted for 7 days. Respiratory distress and cardiomyopathy observed after the lesions disappeared. Also, abnormal laboratory findings included leukocytosis, moderate thrombocytopenia, positive CRP, decreased hemoglobin, increased liver enzymes, and LDH has seen in this patient. One of the differential diagnoses included Kawasaki disease, which ruled out due to the thrombocytopenia and no evidence of this disease in echocardiography and the process of the disease. COVID-19 disease in children might occur with different symptoms and less severe than adults, and might hospitalize less than adults. Coronavirus can cause thrombocytopenia by three mechanisms. One of the mechanisms is direct infection of bone marrow cells and inhibition of platelet synthesis. The other way is destruction of platelets by the immune system. And the last mechanism is the aggregation of the platelets in the lungs, resulting in microthrombi and platelet consumption. A recent study reported a 24-year-old healthy man with severe ITP complicated by intracranial hemorrhage following upper respiratory tract infection. So they illustrated that coronavirus might be a cause of severe ITP. A recent study showed that low platelet count is associated with the increased risk of severe disease and mortality in patients with COVID-19. Also, another study raised the possibility of skin manifestation in coronavirus infection by reporting a case with skin lesions in Thailand. So they suggested that COVID-19 might initially present with skin rash. Also, another study resulted that the most common cutaneous manifestation of COVID-19 was maculopapular exanthema with prevalence of 36.1%. The other common skin manifestations were papulovesicular rash, urticaria, painful acral red, purple papules, livido, reticularis lesions, and petechia, and they occurred before the onset of respiratory symptoms in COVID-19 patients. Only one study reported COVID-19 skin lesions in children until now. This study reported a case of COVID-19 associated varicella-like exanthema from 3 days before referring to the clinic in an 8-year-old girl with mild systemic symptoms in Italy, who had a 6-day history of mild cough and a history of varicella infection a year earlier. The only abnormal laboratory result in this case report was mild thrombocytopenia. Within 7 days, the patient's skin lesion and systemic symptoms improved without any treatment, and the number of platelets returned to the normal. As a conclusion, according to our study, we can conclude that skin lesions and thrombocytopenia in children could be one of the first symptoms of COVID-19 disease. Therefore, if skin manifestation or thrombocytopenia appeared in children, we recommended doing diagnostic tests to rule out COVID-19 disease to prevent the spread of the infection and to monitor the progress of the disease with early diagnosis. Thank you for your attention. Please be safe during this COVID-19 pandemic situation.